Hello and welcome to Neighbourshood. I'm Ben Nicholas, AKA Stingray, and welcome to the first episode. We've got our first guest, Mr. Paul Robinson. Cease, slave. Stefan Dennis, thank you so much for joining us.
My pleasure.
It was a lovely episode.
It was a bit of fun, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was good. I particularly liked the moment when the bikies came in and stole your leg.
They were horrible. They were brutes. I mean, poor defenceless Paul. It's actually one time when you see Paul sort of break down and become a bit of a coward.
Yeah, hey. I've got something for you. Hang on. This is on behalf of all the fans. We'd just like to give you the leg back.
Thank you very much.
I wrapped it myself.
I finally got something to drink out of again.
Yeah. How is that problem going?
Yeah, no, but yeah, good. The leg or the drinking?
Oh, it's one and the same, isn't it?
Yeah.
I remember when they took away your leg, and as an actor, you were like, I'll limp forever. And they were like, nah, we'll get rid of that. And you were like, no, I've stayed true, and you've limped forever.
I've limped forever. Although, it's got to be, I've got to say, it's amazing how many people say, oh, you were in last night's episode, didn't see your limp.
I think you're doing a great job. It's subtle.
Yeah,
it's there,
exactly.
And the good thing is when it's subtle and you have forgotten about it, you know, you can just wipe it off and say, no,
and
it's just subtle.
I never forget, because
it's just so subtle.
Yeah.
What? Oh, that's not even possible.
Two legs.
Yeah, we get the idea, Stefan. Okay, guys, welcome to Neighbourhood Gossip. Now, this section, for Stefan, who you don't know, is when you guys at home get to send in tweets, Facebook comments, all that kind of jazz, and we're gonna read out those comments about the actors and their neighbors' characters on the show, and we're gonna get them to read them out, and then you get to pick which of the ones you think are real and which of the ones you think are fake.
Okay,
yeah, okay, so two of them are real, one's fake, written by yours truly.
It's a bit like I've Got a Secret.
Is it? Is that like some old thing from, it's probably, I was a bit into that.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're gonna go with the first one here.
This is in response to Therese and Paul kissing. Ew.
Yeah, I mean, Paul Robinson kissing anyone is probably horrendous, so I think that's pretty on point, to be honest.
It's too old.
Yeah, too old. Kissing. Yeah, not interested.
Yeah. I absolutely love when Paul laughs on Neighbours. At Dendale, you are an angel. Heart. I think that's like a heart.
Yeah, definitely. I think it is. And the last one?
I hate Paul's laugh on Neighbours.
Interesting. So there's two varying degrees of opinions just then.
Betwixt and between.
Which one do you think is fake?
I'm going to go with the I hate Paul's laugh on Neighbours.
Oh, you are astute. That was the one that I read. Which is ridiculous, because do you laugh again?
Yeah, there you go.
Do it. And I was joking, because it's a brilliant laugh. Pretty good. Sorry, Beck. Love
Except
you.
For the swearing.
We'll beat that out. Producers will love it.
God.
We want you guys to leave some comments, leave some tweets, and let us know what kind of scares and dares you want me or some of the other cast members to do on set, and we'll see if we can achieve those. So make sure you leave some comments, and we'll see if we can get it done for you. Now, hey, Stefan, you were talking to me about something earlier.
Oh, yes, I was. I need to say something very, very important, just off the cuff.
Yep, go.
Oh, Ben. Why haven't you ever come back to Neighbours? You were the most popular character ever and the most handsome, even better looking than Paul, with a way better laugh.
Stop it.
What?
Well, guys, our next section is Bring Back Stingray. Hashtag Bring Back Stingray.
I know how we could do that.
I mean, it's about time.
No, I know how we could do it.
Yeah. Hi, how you going? Just wanted to come see the old office. Wow, this looks the same. When I used to be on the show a few years back. Do you mind if I come in? Tony's cousin! Yes, yes! Now I'm getting somewhere. No, not Tadpole. Okay, you can watch my death on YouTube. Loads of views, they love it. Lots of comments. Bring him back! Whatever.
It was taken so young. What other options do we have? We got nothing.
But do we? Do we have options? Maybe we have options. Potentially this?
Oh, what a crazy dream I've just had. I dreamt that I'd been written out of the... I died. I wonder if that's medically possible to have dreamt for so long.
Yes, that is medically possible.
last 10 years have been Stingray's dream. Huh? It's good. It's good, right? All this? Get rid of it. Wipe it. Clean slate. Like, keep Toadie. He's good. Keep him. He was here when I was there and the other ones. But all the others, recast. Don't need that. Like, who's that one? Who's Aaron? Do you need him? Just saying. Oh, that was brilliant. So you liked my pitch?
I certainly did.
Stingray's coming back on Neighbours.
Yeah.
They said the best thing, the only way it's going to happen is if they take a slice out of your wage and then they just put that towards bringing me back. So I thought it was pretty great. Pretty good idea.
You know how much I get paid out here. So you're
tens of dollars.
Are you going to be able to live on less than the dollar?
Yeah. No, I'll be sweet.
Okay.
I'm living on less than the dollar now. And look at me.
It's more about the... Yeah.
Yeah. So, look, the fans would love to know. They'd love to hear some spoilers about the show. Can you divulge anything for us? Anything that's coming up? Any spicy meatballs?
Yes, of course I can. No, don't be stupid. I'm under contract. Tight-lipped. I'm not allowed to say anything. I could tell you, but then I'd have to kill you, and then I'd have to kill all of you as well. But I do play Paul Robinson, so that's quite feasible.
Well, here's some spoilers we prepared earlier. Stefan, we're here on set, and the audience would love a spoiler.
I'm in hospital, because I hurt myself.
Great, thanks, guys. Back to you in the studio. Wow, thanks for all the spoilers, Stefan, Dennis.
Yeah.
You're nothing if not consistent.
Mm-hmm.
Always got lots to say.
Mm-hmm.
Man of lots of words. So, this next little section we've got is called Caketaker of the Week. Now, do you remember Stingray used to have all those crazy words and lines, spiggin', hufter, caketaker?
Mm-hmm.
Do you remember that kind of stuff?
Yep.
Oh, you got a mind like a sieve, he doesn't remember. Anyway, so what we're going to do is, cake taker of the week is we get a cake, put it on a plate, and we go and deliver it to one of the cast members. Why, you ask? Well, you, the viewers, are going to vote for the biggest idiot of the week. And then we're going to go and deliver a cake to the biggest idiot of the week that's done something silly on Neighbours, and then, they have to eat the cake.
Cast and or crew?
Anyone. Well, no one really cares about the crew, do they? So probably just the cast. You guys get to vote. So let's see who the cake taker is this week. Olivia Valance, you have been voted this week's cake taker of the week. Do you want to read these little tweets that people... So this is you protesting to Sonia's campaign. Just read what these people had to say. Kamira 96, just read that.
How rude was she? Trying to be like her uni...
You're a good reader. Let me go. How rude was she? Trying to be liked by her new uni friends. Sad and pathetic, Paige.
I get
sad
it.
Sad and pathetic. And then
no, there's some spelling mistakes. It's not just
the next
me.
One's good. Horrid, rude, disgusting person. You're horrid.
So why do I get the cake?
Because you've been a huge cake taker of the week and you've got to put it in your mouth.
Okay.
Eat it.
Another top-up, sir?
That'd be great.
Yeah.
Go on. The props department would kill you.
Yes, they would indeed.
Stefan Dennis, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for coming on the show.
Thank you, sir.
Now, before we leave you, please, a real teaser for this week. Have you got a little bit of a storyline for us, a little bit of information? Come on, the fans want to know. Come on, a little bit.
You're adamant.
I'm grilling you like a sausage.
Okay, all right, I'll tell you what. How about if I tell you that Mark Brennan is going to fall for somebody who's not Paige?
Not Paige?
Yeah.
Is it you? It's you, isn't it?
No.
Oh, come on. Listen. Yeah?
If Paige is Lauren Turner's daughter, does that make her a real Paige Turner?
Oh, Dad. Oh, that was ridiculous.
Yeah.
That was terrible. I'm really sad to say that we have to finish the show on that sad, sad joke. But please join us every Monday for the fan show. And make sure you tune in to Neighbours this week and tomorrow. And here's a little clip of what's coming up next.
Mm-hmm. Oh,